Alrighty guys, what's going on? Linky here, and in today's video, we are going to be discussing the breaking news that we got from Nintendo yesterday, which is that we have now officially seen the Nintendo Switch OLED edition, which is a name I will never be able to fully get used to. Let's discuss it. It feels like it's been years now that we've been speculating, discussing, and almost expecting a brand new Switch model to be announced that improves performance, that is beefier, better battery life, better performance, better looking, bigger screen, all the different things that eventually go into what the rumor became of the future Nintendo Switch Pro. The Switch Pro, the thing that we had been expecting and hoping and praying exists for years now. And I'm not going to say that it's unlikely that we ever see a Nintendo Switch Pro, but it certainly doesn't look too good right now, because yesterday Nintendo officially unveiled the Nintendo Switch OLED model. That is the name. I'm not even going to comment on the fact that it's just the name of the Switch and the name of the type of screen they're using combined. I will leave that for you guys in the comment section to rip apart, because you guys are much better at that than I am. But this is the brand new Switch model. It's being priced at $349.99 MSRP, $350, $50 more than the Nintendo Switch current model is, and like $150 less than the Nintendo Switch Lite. So that's where it's going to be priced. It is not succeeding the original Switch. It is not taking the place of the original Switch. It is not more powerful than the original Switch. It's more powerful than the original Switch, but it's not more powerful than the current version of the Nintendo Switch. There was the revision a couple years back, if you guys don't remember that. Now, before we discuss this any further, I just wanted to mention that the vast majority of you guys who are watching these videos and hopefully, enjoying them, aren't subscribed to the channel. Now, if you don't want to miss any uploads that I ever do when it comes to Pokemon, Nintendo, or other video game news, please be sure to go down below, hit that subscribe button, and you'll get the videos in your feed every time I upload. We're going to go over some of the specs here, give my thoughts in general. Let's talk about this model, first of all. Now, as I mentioned before, there is no known performance boost on this model. It has the same CPU, has the same amount of RAM, it has the same battery life as the current Nintendo Switch does. What is different about this model is that it has a longer and more flexible kickstand on the back. It has a much larger 7-inch 720p screen, which is using OLED technology. The flap for game cases is redesigned in a way. It also has more internal storage. The original Switch model had 32 gigs of internal storage. This new Switch OLED model has 64 gigs of internal storage. Is 64 gigs enough for someone who wants to buy a ton of digital games? No, it is not. It is absolutely not enough, and you should probably still get a micro SD card if you're interested in owning a Switch and you're interested in having a digital library. I'd recommend a 128 gig, but that's just me. So that's pretty much all of the major pieces. One of the other things they mentioned in the video is it has improved audio quality, so the speakers are apparently going to be better on this Switch model. We have yet to hear them, so we don't exactly know what to expect from that, but that is coming. The other thing that's important to note from this trailer is that it has a brand new dock. The dock has a built-in LAN port now, so you can connect right to Ethernet, and you can have a better internet connection when you're playing multiplayer games. The dock is redesigned. It's more curved than the original dock. It's white. The Nintendo Switch logo on the dock will also glow when you plug your Switch in. But it's also important to note that all of this is backwards compatible. The Switch OLED model will work in the original Nintendo Switch dock. The normal Nintendo Switch will work in the OLED model dock. Joy-Cons from the original Switch will work 100% with this new Switch OLED. The new Switch OLED white Joy-Cons are just that. They're white Joy-Cons, to the extent that we don't even know if Joy-Con drift is a fixed issue here or if it still remains. Those Joy-Cons will work with your old Switch. All of this is backwards compatible with one another. And of course, obviously, because there's no performance change, all of your games from the original Switch will work with the Switch OLED. This is not a new 3DS XL situation where there were a handful of games that were made that only really ran well, and saying they ran well is putting it loosely, on the new Nintendo 3DS model. That's not that situation. This Switch console is for people who maybe don't have a Switch yet and want to get the best one possible, which would be the Switch OLED because it's got the better screen, or it's for Switch users who maybe bought the original Switch model at launch, never got the refreshed version a couple years later, want and play handheld. If you play a ton of handheld on the Nintendo Switch, this model is, in my opinion, probably worth the upgrade. The new screen is fantastic. For anybody who's never seen an OLED screen before, because I know there are people out there who might not have an OLED TV, never saw a PS Vita when like 10 people owned that. OLED screens are gorgeous. They bring out so much vibrance in the colors of a game and the colors of video. There is some concern about burn-in with OLED screens, to where if you keep one image on the pixels for very long, eventually that image might get burned into the screen, but that was almost never an issue with the Vita, so for video games, that really doesn't seem to be much of a concern. That's a lot more of a concern with some OLED TVs, some older OLED TVs back when the technology wasn't as refined. But the screen is going to be gorgeous, and the screen stretches to the edges of the Switch hardware itself. One of the biggest criticisms of the original Nintendo Switch, and honestly of the Lite too, is that you have these enormous bezels around the screen in it. When you look at the OLED Switch and then you look back to looking at the current Switch, you can definitely see that it's not a looker. Compared to the OLED model, the new Switch looks like one of those old iPads with the enormous bezels on the sides, or a computer monitor with enormous bezels around the screen. It doesn't look as high-tech, it doesn't look as sleek. This new OLED Switch with the black and white color scheme, which I know some people aren't down with it. We saw a lot of reactions when the PS5 was unveiled about that black and white color scheme. A lot of people don't really love it too much, but personally, I absolutely love the black and white color scheme. So the new Joy-Cons are great, the new dock is great, and it goes really well with the Switch, with the black Switch piece of hardware itself, as well as with the new OLED screen. The kickstand I mentioned before is a lot bigger. It's, if you've ever seen a Surface Pro, which is the tablet laptop, it's got one of those kickstands that you can virtually extend as far as you want and get any viewing angle you want. And it's also a lot sturdier. The original Switch kickstand was this little small piece of plastic that you could literally rip off, and under that piece of plastic is where you had the micro SD card slot. That's no more. It's a long kickstand. In the trailer, they made a very conscious effort to mention how long it was. So, I mean, that's a thing. Like I said, under the hood, it's the same thing. It's got the exact same processor. It's got the NVIDIA custom, it's got a custom NVIDIA Tegra processor. It's got the same amount of RAM. It's got the same battery life, 4.5 to 9 hours. It is a Nintendo Switch with a better screen and nicer external features. We don't know a lot about Bluetooth connectivity just yet. We don't know specifically what this improved audio is going to look like. We haven't seen it hands-on yet. We've just had this one video. And that remains to be seen. We will see how all of those features turn out. But the question is, are we disappointed by this? We were expecting for years a Nintendo Switch Pro. There were rumors in multiple quote-unquote trusted news sources that the Switch Pro was going to have 4K output to TVs, was going to have a 1080p screen in handheld mode. They never speculated. There were some recent rumors that speculated about an OLED screen, but for the most part, those rumors were just that it would have an improved screen. This is just the screen. The rumors, it's very interesting. The rumors got almost every hardware piece correct, at least on the outside, that it would work with the older Switch model, better kickstand, better screen, better internal storage. But when it comes to performance details, every single one was wrong. This is the same Switch on the inside. Besides maybe some better cavities for sound quality, this is the same Switch. For those people who have been waiting a long time, people who might not have the Nintendo Switch and were thinking, I want to get the Switch, I want to play Smash, I want to play Mario Kart, I want to play Zelda, I want to play Pokemon, but I want to wait for that big Switch Pro. I don't know when you're going to get it. Nintendo recently said that we're in the middle of the Switch's hardware life cycle, which means we might have 3 to 4 years left of the Nintendo Switch. I can't see them unveiling a new Switch hardware next year. Maybe in 2023, we could see a new Switch model, a beefier Switch model, or maybe we don't get an improved Switch model until the Switch's successor, until we see a Nintendo Switch 2, as you may call it. That's very possible. If you're someone who had the original Switch, but you don't have the new model, so your battery life is a lot worse, you might have some scrapes and some bruises on your Switch, I think this model is worth considering because it's only $50 more than the current Switch right now. But if you have that refurbished model and you're someone who plays in docked mode for the most part, I don't think this is worth an upgrade. I don't think the Switch screen is going to be a big selling point for you. And if you're someone who doesn't have a Switch and you want to jump on board and you want to get the best one possible, the one that can be played in portable and can be played in docked, I think it's probably worth your time to consider upgrading, not upgrading, purchasing, becoming an adopter of this model, because I'm not sure how long you're going to have to wait for the rumored fabled Switch Pro. With that being said, those are my thoughts on the new Nintendo Switch model. We did get some other news in this trailer. We saw some Pokemon footage. I'm going to have a video going over that in detail later on in the week. So, like I mentioned before, if you're not subscribed, hit that subscribe button so you don't miss that upload, because we got a lot to say about that new little, very small piece of video. I'm very good at stretching Pokemon discussions. We're going to stretch this one because I have a lot to say. I'd love to hear and know what you guys think. Do you like this new Switch model? Do you think it's disappointing based on all of the rumors about the Switch Pro? And if you're a Switch user, are you going to upgrade? If you're not a Switch user, but you're interested in getting one, are you going to pick up this model? I would love to hear what you guys think down in the comments section below. And as always, I've been Linky. I'll see y'all in the next video. Peace out.